Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is from Maurice Insights. Take it off. Douglas Murray destroys Muslama. That's what I'm saying. Is it a Muslim woman wearing niqab or is it hijab? Maybe it's my own decision. I'm not wearing niqab or is it hijab and leaves her speechless. Let's check it out.
I'm concerned. The bullies are winning here. There is a majority of people who have the power and resources to put out there an image about the niqab. I teach in schools and I said to a young bunch of children, I said to them, if somebody came into your...
You're about to witness one of the most heated debates where Douglas Murray absolutely obliterates some Islamic women scholars about their choice to wear the niqab. These are the kind of topics that the left-wing media wants you to shy away from. But Douglas is not afraid to say what we are all thinking publicly.
Can I just begin with you, Fatima?
Yes.
56% of British people don't really support the wearing of the full face veil in public. They don't want it.
Well, I think it depends on where you take the poll, really, because, something that I've recently launched is a project called Secrets of a Muslim Woman, and it's all about letting people know why we do what we do, because I think a lot of it is to do with not really being familiar with it. You know, I mean, my message to the British public is that you've got nothing to fear. You know,
but they don't feel that though, do they? Because elsewhere in this poll, a majority said they don't know how to relate to a woman wearing a full face veil.
I think, you know, the people who have actually interacted with women who wear the face veil, people who work with them, I mean, we're in East London today. In East London, the veil is practically, you know, normal on the streets of East London. People who've actually interacted and worked with women who wear the veil have absolutely no problem.
Douglas is about to let her eat her words in a second. But it's important to recognise the importance of transparency and open communication in society. Douglas's stance against the niqab aligns with the values of openness and trust that are foundational to our community. If you cover your face, it creates a barrier that prevents effective interaction and understanding between individuals. This lack of visibility can promote suspicion and fear, as people are naturally wary.
Yeah, which I understand that fear. Actually, let me not lie. I'm here in Nigeria and I know that this is because we are partly Christian and partly Muslim in my country, and I know it's allowed, but let me not lie. A lot of us, when we see them on the road, we don't, because you don't know who is behind it. You don't know who is there. So I thought if they have any genuine friends, how will you have friends? Because most of those women that cover up like that is instructions from their husbands. Because if you check, most of them are married. You hardly see single Muslim women that go all about covering all like that. When you see a Muslim woman covering all like that, she's married and it's her husband's standards making her do that. Most of them even wear socks. They will cover, they wear black gloves, they wear black socks. I don't think I've ever even communicated with any of them. And if you see them on the road, they don't even stop to communicate to people. Most, this is me just sharing from my own personal opinion. So even I myself, I'll be reluctant in communicating with them, or even like going further to establish a relationship, any kind of relationship, whatever, with them, because I don't know who is behind it. I don't know what your face look like, because I know it will be hard for me to see your face unless if I go to your house. And for you to even like, it's a whole lot. So I understand where they're coming from. And let's be honest, when you go to Islamic Muslim countries, you are expected to abide by their own rules. I think it's knowledge that everybody knows. We're expected to abide, but I've never seen people saying, why is that when I go to Saudi Arabia or some of all these countries, Sunday is a work day. Why is it like that? I'm a Christian. Why should I be? I've never seen anybody lay such complaints. So why should I be doing that when they go to another country? It doesn't make sense.
Of what they cannot see or understand. Moreover, in a society that values equality and freedom, the niqab can be seen as a symbol of oppression, particularly against women. It is essential to protect the societal values that promote gender equality and individual freedom. By discouraging the wearing of the niqab, we are not only fostering a more transparent and cohesive society, but also standing up for the rights and dignity of women.
The fear of the unknown.
Douglas Murray, would you like to see the veil banned here?
Well, I think, like a majority of British people, I think that it should be banned in public places, particularly places like courtrooms, where it's absolutely imperative that a jury are able to see the faces of people who are accused. As for an overall ban, I think, look, my own opinion is that niqab is highly undesirable. I think that we live in a society where people do show their faces, where huge amounts of our social interaction depend on people showing their faces. I think that it's very difficult to enforce a ban in public places like streets, but it should be certainly a desirable thing to discourage its wearing.
To impose a ban, but in principle you'd like to see one because you think in Britain it's unacceptable.
In public buildings, in courts, in schools and places like this, absolutely, I think a ban would be very sensible. In streets and so on, I think it's difficult, but it should be society.
Douglas is spot on to call for banning the niqab in public places, especially in critical settings like courtrooms and schools. This is a move towards maintaining societal integrity and transparency. In our society, the ability to see and recognize each other is fundamental to building trust and ensuring justice. Covering your face with a niqab disrupts this essential aspect of social interaction and can lead to misunderstandings and mistrust. Also, public institutions such as courts and schools are pillars of our community where transparency and equality must be upheld. Allowing the niqab in these settings can be dangerous, as it could compromise the fairness of judicial proceedings and the educational environment. While a complete ban on the niqab in all public places might be challenging to enforce, promoting a societal norm that encourages open and visible interactions aligns with our values of honesty, trust, and equality.
We have spoken to women who say that they cover their faces because they don't want to incite passions among men. I mean, that is essentially Yasmin's point.
Well, look, essentially, I think, you know, that's Yasmin's opinion.
No, it's not my opinion.
Yes,
that
it is. What is your opinion?
Ask the Taliban. Ask Taliban why they're imposing it.
Yasmin, you know, I'm really sorry. Maybe you haven't really met women in niqab. I would like to invite you out to my house. You know, you can see my face. We can sit together. We can have a laugh.
Yes, but I think it will change your...
You see, like what I said, you have to go to their house before you are able to see their face. In other words, see, me, I just see this as a man. There are men trying to, you know, be insecure that I'm the only one that will see my wife's face. Other women can see my wife, but other men should not see my wife's face. I've never understood that. And these women arguing this, they don't even have a choice in it. Even if they want or they don't, like, so long as their husband insists that they should wear a cap, they don't have a choice. So, some of you fighting for it's her body, her choice. It's not Islam. In Islam, it's not like that. It's not about your choice. So no matter your choice, if your husband wants you to wear a niqab, you will wear it. That's how it is. Your husband is the one that will decide if you are wearing it or not. It's not even about you, the woman.
Your opinion. Come to your house and see your face, though, could he?
I can assure you, I'm not going to be
aroused. He could meet my husband.
What these women in niqab fail to understand is that women covering their faces is only to prevent.
Why did you cut it? You would have allowed her to say, you can meet my husband. Did you hear what she's saying? You would have allowed this video to let's hear her opinion. She does not have a say. Who, if a man to see her face on, she does not have a say. So long as her husband has not permitted it, she does not have a say.
Douglas your opinion.
Come to your house and see your face, though, could he?
I can assure you I'm not going
to
be aroused.
He could meet my husband.
What these women in niqab fail to understand is that women covering their faces is only to prevent inciting passions among men, which is not only outdated.
Well, I don't agree to you saying it's outdated. For the fact, it's just like saying, because I'm a Christian, Christianity is now outdated. I should stop believing what the Bible says. I don't agree to that. It's not about being outdated. What me I'm even saying about is that you can't bring your religion or law from your country and come to another man's country and you want them to abide by it. Meanwhile, if that man goes to your country, your country will not, you know, change their values and law to adapt that man. That's what me I'm saying. So it's not even about whether it's outdated or this is 2020. No, that's not the issue here, please.
But also undermines the principles of personal responsibility and self-control. We live in a society that values equality and open communication. It is very important that individuals can interact face-to-face, fostering trust and understanding. In addition to that, the notion that men cannot control their passions unless women cover their faces is a disservice to both genders. It places an unfair burden on women and diminishes the moral responsibility of men. By supporting a ban on the niqab in public places, we are advocating for a society where individuals are judged by their character and actions, not by their appearance.
okay?
We accommodate religious expression in this country. You know, Jehovah's Witnesses who don't want blood transfusions, Sikh people who want to wear turbans. We make exceptions, you know, in certain situations. And so, look, you know, I really want to reach out to the public and say, you've got nothing to fear from us.
But take up Yasmin's
point. I was born in this country. I love
point.
This country.
Take up Yasmin's point that this is about exceptionalism. Take up Yasmin Alibi Brown's point about this is about exceptionalism.
We accommodate, don't we, in this country, and in my country, Britain, we accommodate religious expression. And we do make exceptions for people. And there's nothing, and that's what I thought.
And we cannot
growing
destroy
up in this country,
the minorities
but,
and the religious belief in the name of equality.
But what if the majority feel uncomfortable, feel uneasy and say they don't want to?
I think then the onus is on us as well, isn't it? I mean, to actually reach out. And I'm hoping that this is just going one step towards that, to say to people, look, you know, we're human beings just like
but,
you.
But if I missed you.
As Douglas rightly said, societal cohesion and transparency are important. While it is true that we accommodate various forms of religious expression, such as Jehovah's Witnesses refusing blood transfusions or Sikhs wearing turbans, the niqab presents a unique challenge. Unlike other religious symbols, the niqab covers the face, which is fundamental to human interaction and trust. In public spaces, particularly in institutions like courts and schools or even the park, the ability to see and recognize each other is essential. It ensures accountability and promotes a sense of community. While we should respect religious beliefs, there must also be a balance. If the majority feels uneasy or uncomfortable with the niqab, it is crucial to address these concerns. Upholding societal values of openness and equality sometimes means making difficult decisions that Douglas is brave enough to talk about, and in this case, it's support for a ban on the niqab.
I mean, just, if I may,
we
very
have
quickly,
to hold
religious freedom is an extremely important thing, and I think most people would agree, I hope, in this room, that Britain is the most tolerant place in the world to live, including as a Muslim.
Yeah.
But let's just add one thing to this, if I may. The issue of social interaction is very important, and not just to me, but obviously to a majority of the British people.
Exactly.
What I say tonight,
exactly.
What Yasmin says and other people say tonight,
exactly.
People see our faces, they know who said it. I'm sorry to say this, but nobody knows who you are. They can hear your name, they can't see you.
Fatima.
If I say something stupid on television tonight, people know it's me saying it. If you do, with all due respect, you can disappear and no one knows.
No, we're not disappearing. You
can't
see us here. Come
on. The meaning of this thing is extremely important to address. The meaning of this thing is women are by nature dangerous to men and society. Therefore, they must be covered. They must be buried. That's the meaning of it. And that.
Douglas Murray's rebuttal is spot on, as it emphasizes a critical point. Social interaction and accountability are fundamental to any peaceful society. In Britain, where transparency and open communication are valued, the niqab then poses a significant barrier. When we speak or act in public, our faces and identities are visible, ensuring that we are accountable for our words and actions. This transparency promotes trust and mutual respect. Finally, Douglas offers us the only solution possible at this moment, and a horrifying example of the consequences that await us if we don't act. The idea that women must be covered from head to toe to prevent them from being dangerous to men is deeply troubling. It not only undermines the dignity of women, but also suggests that men lack the self-control to interact with women respectfully. This ideology is not only outdated, but also incompatible with the values of equality and personal responsibility.
This is what I don't understand, yeah? You move away from your country because you want some level of freedom as a woman, because you know that in your country you don't have freedom to speak as to the way a man will speak, and people don't even know who you are because your face is constantly covered when you are in public. So there are only a selected few people that know you, no matter the name you make. Let's say, for instance, you make this name, which even your country will not even really make it, because you will not be allowed to make such, you know, huge achievement. So you make this huge name. Nobody even knows your face. They only know the name. Anybody can come up and claim that he's the one. So you leave all that because you want freedom of speech. You come to a country where people are allowed to say their mind, to be themselves. You know, my body, my choice. The country where such is allowed. You come to that country, yet you want to impose what you're running away from on that same country. Does that even make sense? What do you want? Like, I really want to understand what people like this, what they want. do you want to go back to that country and start, you know, living that life, or you want to stay in this country and adapt to the country's way of life, or you want the country to change and to adopt, to, you know, to change so that you'll be able to adopt to the country? I don't even know what you exactly want. I would love to know what your thoughts are in the comment section. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Take care of yourself, guys. Bye.